Good evening, children. I hope everyone are doing fine. Let us continue with the chapter 2, acid bases and salts. In today's class we will study about how do acids and bases react with each other, reaction of metallic oxide with acids, as well as reaction of non-metallic oxides with base. So let us begin with the class. Coming to neutralization. So what do you mean by neutralization? So it is nothing but the reaction between an acid and a base is known as neutralization. So whatever the reaction is happening between acid and base, that is said to be neutralization. And product formed as salt and water along with the evolution of heat. Here in the equation you can see acid reacting with base gives rise to salt plus water. Along with that, heat has been evolved. For example, hydrochloric acid, that is HCl, is reacting with sodium hydroxide, that is NaOH. So what is the product formed? That is common salt, sodium chloride, NaCl and water, isn't it? So let us see neutralization in our daily life. So before that, we shall see how neutralization occurs in case of acids and bases. Okay, so when acids and bases react, so what is going to happen? We will see. We have learned that acid turns blue litmus red and bases turns red litmus blue. Now, let us see what happens when an acid is mixed with a base. So, we are going to use an indicator. So, we have not used so far this indicator. Okay, it is called as phenolphthalein. So, how do you pronounce it, children? It is phenolphthalein indicator. Okay, and here is an experimental setup to understand this much better. So what we need to do is we need to take two test tubes. In one test tube, we need to fill 1/4 of this with dilute hydrochloric acid, that is dilute HCl. And we should note down its color in prior. Okay, now we need to note down the color of phenolphthalein. So what is the color of phenolphthalein? It is something like purplish pink, right? Now, we need to note down this color of phenolphthalein as well. Okay, now we need to add 2 to 3 drops of indicator to the acid and we need to shake it gently. Okay, now we need to observe, is there any color change of acid? Okay, now to this acidic solution, a drop of sodium hydroxide solution we need to add by dropper, and next we need to stir it gently. Here, sodium hydroxide is a base, right? And we need to observe, is there any change in color of the solution? And we should continue adding the sodium hydroxide solution drop by drop while stirring it till the pink color just appears. Okay, it has to appear in a pink color. Now we need to add one more drop of dilute hydrochloric acid. What do you observe? The solution again becomes colorless. Okay. Again, add one drop of sodium hydroxide solution and we need to observe, is there any change in color? So again, the solution becomes pink in color. So it is an evident that when a solution is basic, phenolphthalein gives a pink color. On the other hand, when the solution is acidic, it remains colorless. Okay. When an acidic solution is mixed with basic solution, both the solution neutralizes the effect of each other. Okay, when an acid solution and a base solution are mixed in suitable amounts, both the acidic of the acid and the basic nature of the base are destroyed and the resulting solution is neither acidic nor basic. Now we need to touch the test tube immediately after neutralization. Okay, now what we observe is in neutralization reaction, heat is always produced, as you saw in previous slide, and also heat is evolved. The evolved heat raises the temperature of the reaction that is there in the mixture. Okay, now in neutralization reaction, a new substance what is formed is, that is salt. Salt may be acidic, basic or neutral in nature. Thus, this neutralization can be defined as I explained in the first slide. Okay, now let us see neutralization in everyday life. Okay. So neutralization happens in everyday life, like in case of indigestion, ant bite, soil treatment and also factory wastes. So let us study one by one in detail. So first, coming to indigestion. So we know that our stomach contains hydrochloric acid, and it helps us to digest food. So as you have learned in previous lessons, right? So, but too much of acid in the stomach always causes indigestion, right? Sometimes indigestion is so painful. To relieve this indigestion, we take an antacid, which I have mentioned in previous topic as well. So your antacids such as milk of magnesia, which contains magnesium hydroxide, and it neutralizes the effect of excessive acid. Okay, like antacid pills you will get, and gelosil. So people who are suffering with acidity, they take this, okay, to neutralize the substance, right? To neutralize this acid. So we take antacids in the case of indigestion. Next is ant bite. So we know that an ant bites, when an ant bites, it injects the acidic liquid, that is formic acid, into the skin. So the effect of acid can be neutralized by rubbing moist baking soda, that is sodium hydrogen carbonate, or calamine solution, which contains zinc carbonate. Okay, so we know that the acid present in the ant is formic acid. So when it bites, what happens? You'll get small blisters on the ant. So to avoid this, because the acid has entered into the skin, and to avoid this, we need to rub a baking soda, moist baking soda, on the affected part. So baking soda chemical name is nothing but sodium hydrogen carbonate, or we can use calamine solution also, so which contains zinc carbonate. It acts like a base and it neutralizes. Okay, next is soil treatment. So excessive use of chemical fertilizers that makes the soil acidic. Okay, so when there is a excessive usage of chemical fertilizers, what happens to the soil? It becomes more acidic. So plants do not grow well when the soil is either too acidic or too basic. Okay, so when the soil is too acidic, what happens? It is treated with the base like quick lime, that is calcium oxide, or a slaked lime called as calcium hydroxide. So if the soil is too basic, so organic matter, that is compost, is added to that. Organic matter releases acids which neutralizes the basic nature of the soil. So that is why before growing any crop in a large scale, they undertake soil test. So the pH of soil has to be tested, because all crops doesn't require too much acidic soil or too much basic soil. Okay, some plants grow in a some acidic conditions, some basic conditions. So this has to be tested before growing any sort of crops, that too in a large scale. Okay, next, in case of factory wastes, the waste of many factories contains acid. So if they are allowed to flow it in the water bodies, so the acids will kill aquatic organisms, that is fish and other aquatic animals. Okay, so the factory wastes are therefore neutralized by adding basic substance, so that it gonna neutralize, okay, and avoid water pollution also. Next is reaction of metallic oxides with acids, and also reaction of non-metallic oxides with base. So coming to reaction of metallic oxides with acids, for this we have a small activity. So we need to take a small amount of copper oxide in a beaker, and we should add dilute hydrochloric acid slowly while stirring. And we know what is the nature of oxides, so that is basic in nature, right? And we need to note down the color of the solution, what has happened to the copper oxide. So we will notice that the color of the solution becomes blue-green, and the copper oxide will dissolve in that. And the blue-green color of the solution is due to the formation of copper 2-chloride in the reaction. So because of the reaction, the product formed is copper 2-chloride. This leads to the blue-green color. Okay, so the general reaction between a metal oxide and an acid can be written as metal oxide plus acid, that gives rise to salt plus water. Okay, so coming to this one, we need to write and balance the equation for the above reaction. That is your small homework. Since metal oxides react with acid to give salt and water, similar to the reaction of a base with an acid, metallic oxides are said to be basic oxides. Okay, so now reaction of non-metallic oxide with base. So we saw the reaction between carbon dioxide and calcium hydroxide, that is lime water, in the previous activities. So calcium hydroxide is nothing but a base, right? Where it reacts with carbon dioxide to produce a salt and water. So since this is similar to the reaction between a base and an acid, we can conclude that non-metallic oxides are acidic in nature. So children, I hope everyone had followed today's concept. No worksheet for the day because I've given a lot of notes to complete. So do complete that and see you all. Have a good day.